Here they come.
Good.
Highball freight, number 56. Block. Entire line. Impassable. Hold all trains.
Get me Dan Thorne. Port all along the main line.
Oh, why don't somebody get me Dan Thorne? He's the only man can handle this. I'm trying to get him. Half my paperwork ruined again because he's out tramping the yard when he should be here to give me authority.
What's coming off around here?
Did you guys play railroad anymore today?
There's a landslide, the new cut. The entire division is held up
right
the peak of traffic. My schedule's all ripped to pieces, and we've had to hold up the Limited.
Hold up the Olympia? You off your nut, tell her to come through.
What's the half a mountain slidin' on that track?
I'll clear the track. Don't stand there looking at me. Lift those lift boards and keep traffic moving. You, blast the boardroom to blow the whistle and get the wreck crew out. Okay. You, phone Ed Ryan. I won't be home to dinner tonight. Give me a piece of that. You off this guy. Put the Olympian in the hole.
Looking at labor like that, it's made a hobo out of me.
Can you imagine? On a day like this?
The trouble with labor is the work that's connected with it. Now, I figured that work is for workers. So why bother your head about it?
Hey, Joe, keep this bug over, will you?
Listen, Dan, we can't make it. We've got to send back for more men.
What? Lose this line, block another hour? Not on your life.
Hey, listen, there's not a man in 10 miles.
Caram, boys, caram.
Come on, come on.
Mr. Thorne, I'm a conscientious objector to manual labor in any form.
Get over there, get over there.
I yield only to superior force.
Come on.
Very good arguments for that.
Listen, I work when I want to, and I don't want to now.
No? Vaughn. This is an extremely dangerous spot.
Right here.
Get over there.
All clear, Dan.
Okay.
Take it away!
Joe.
See that fella down there?
Put him in the caboose and throw a feed into him. But Danny's only a tramp.
I don't know.
There's something about that guy.
Take him along.
All right. Hey, a couple of you fellas come with me.
Division Super 2, and he was about your size.
Well, you must think you're as tough as I am.
Well, if you and me has blown enough smoke for now, I'll be on my way.
Now, some people would let you do just that. Me, I'm going to give you a chance to put some of them guts into a job.
Work on a railroad again? No chance. The Red's against you, Super.
On this road and for me. I'm Dan Thorne, and what I say goes around here. That means everybody, see?
Yeah. Everybody but me.
Joe. I'd like to have a new man for your cellar packer job.
You know engine?
Sure, just to work on the Lake Division. Go ahead and meet Joe Gary, the roundhouse foreman.
Oh, glad to know you. Dan said you're all right. It's okay with me. Get busy on the big boy here. It's next out.
Hey, ah, boy, there's your job.
Yeah. So you think I'm working, huh?
If them jail boxes ain't greased in half an hour, it'll drain the heart out of you, big fella.
Sure. But I ain't working, understand? I ain't working. That's a fine way to leave an engine.
Shop,
Dan.
I'll see you later.
All right. Hey, Dan. I was wondering if I could lay off on the next run. Why, Tom, you ain't put in for anything like that in 20 years.
Well, you see, well, I...
Oh, it's the wife. Ain't she no better yet?
She's worse, Dan. Much worse.
So you got everything you need? You got a good doctor?
Yes, but I'm just a little frightened, Dan.
You go right back to her, and don't you let me see you around these yards till she's absolutely all right.
Thanks.
Go on, go on.
Hey, you know, Dan, if anything happens to Tom, he'll hit the booze again, sure.
He knows better than that. Why, I'd have to rule him off the road.
But you know what he used to be.
That's right. Chuck, keep an eye on him. And if anything happens, let me know quick.
You're always thinking of me, ain't you?
Sure, no man had a better daughter than I have.
The birds will hear you.
Look here, will you? The Donahue brothers are giving away a kitchen table and two chairs to every newly married couple this month. Now, that's something for you to look forward to.
Well, that's quite an inducement, isn't it?
It is. I must show this to Dan.
Oh! Don't you dare!
Let go. Why shouldn't I show it to him? He's a man that understands. Where is he? I haven't seen him today.
What time is it?
Oh. There you are. Another minute you'd been late.
Not a chance. You wouldn't think I'd be late with you waiting for me, Mary, would you? Hey, I'm going to enter a complaint. Somebody's getting a lot of attention around here besides me.
Sure, go on, Eddie. You wouldn't be jealous of her own father, would you?
Wouldn't I? Say, I'm likely to be jealous of anybody.
What's that?
Oh, yes. Say, Mary, I want you to do something for me. I want you to go down the roundhouse. I got a new man down there. He's a floater, and his name is Doyle. Give him this bundle and this note and see what he does, huh?
Now, Dan, I wish you wouldn't bother your head about those tramps. You know, it never turns out right.
Mary, a fella can go wrong a dozen times. But if you're right once, it makes up for all the rest. Will you do it?
Well, all right.
Well, I got here just in time, didn't I?
You did that.
I did.
Answer now?
Yeah.
All right, just tell Thorne there's no chance. I'm quitting.
I thought you would.
Why, wait a minute. What do you mean you thought I would? What makes you think I'm a quitter? You think I'm here because I like it? Well, I'm not, and I'm leaving. I'm not gonna...
All right. Suit yourself.
Wait a minute. Hey, wait a minute. What do you mean, suit myself? We ought to kind of talk this over, hadn't we? You live here permanently?
she's a lucky girl. I've often said it, she's a lucky girl to be marrying a railroader and a fine-looking man, too.
Hey, hey, stop throwing them apples. Give me a match, will you?
But you are, Dan. You are. Maybe not exactly handsome, but...
No.
But handsome is as handsome does.
Not exactly handsome. Why, my pan looks like a street before they laid the pavement down.
You wouldn't find Mary saying a thing like that. Oh, you're going to make her happy, Dan.
I never failed to do anything I wanted to yet.
You sure haven't, boy. You're always kingpin amongst us, even in the old days. And ever since I got my smash, and you started to take care of me and Mary...
Pipe down.
Why, you're more than just a man to us.
Hey, stop it. You have me blushing.
Maybe I didn't say the right words, boy, but... You know how I feel, don't you?
You don't owe me a thing. If it had been the other way around, you'd have done the same thing to me. Sit still, lad. I'll see who it is.
Yeah, this is the right place. Come on in. Well, how do you feel?
Okay, here.
Come and have a bite to eat.
No, thanks.
Wait a minute. Meet Ed Ryan. We live here together. Ed, this is Larry Doyle.
Hi. Glad to meet you.
You better put in some fuel. We just took off the nose bag ourselves, but there's plenty of grub on the stove yet. And before you do that, maybe you better go upstairs and clean up a little. I left some clothes out for you. And when you're decent, why, come right on down.
Thanks. I guess I need him at that.
Go on. It's to the left. Hilda?
Yeah?
Set another place on the table and keep supper hot on the stove, will you?
Yeah. Hey, Phil.
All right.
Is that the boomer engineer you were talking about?
Yeah, that's the kid. Should have seen him talk back to me. Try to fight me and him 2 days away from his last square meal. He's a game kid. I know that kind. They wind up in a jail or a general manager's job.
Yeah, in a jail most likely. I never saw one of those floaters yet that panned out right.
Ain't you?
No, I haven't.
Well, you're looking at one right now. Say, if I hadn't got kicked in the pants by a couple of old rails like you, I'd have been a floater yet. That kid's gonna make a good hoghead. Say, what's happened to Mary? Is she coming down?
She's upstairs primping up for you.